I lived in Eugene, there was a festival every September called the Eugene Celebration. In addition to food and entertainment booths over the weekend, there was a parade on Saturday morning. And one of the traditions was that parade was that our congressional representative, Peter DeFazio, always volunteered to come last in the parade, scooping up the droppings left by any of the horses that had been in the parade. It sort of fit with his image as a man of the people, someone who didn't take himself too seriously, etc. The role of pooper scooper is a necessary part of any parade that has animals, but it certainly isn't a role that is usually highlighted or celebrated. It isn't a particularly pleasant job, especially compared to all the fun and excitement that the rest of the parade is all about. But then, not everything about a parade is fun and exciting. Whether it's having to clean up after animals, or having to arrive early in the morning if you're a participant, or perhaps having to endure hours of hot or cold weather, or perhaps even rain, in order to watch a parade in person. The crowds that lined up to welcome Jesus along the road to Jerusalem over 2,000 years ago didn't know that not everything about Jesus' messiahship was going to be fun either. They thought that Jesus was the Messiah, which to them meant someone who would be a political or military leader, someone to drive out the Romans and restore Israel as an independent state. When they shouted, "Hosanna," which means save us, they were looking to be saved from the Romans, not from sin. The events of the week that followed, even the events of that day, would show that Jesus was not the typical Messiah that the crowds, or even his disciples, had been expecting. In this procession that Jesus makes to Jerusalem, he is riding on a colt, in particular one that has never been ridden before. This is not a full-grown, well-trained horse that one would expect of a military or political leader. And instead of a proper saddle, there were only a couple of cloaks thrown over the colt for Jesus to sit on. What kind of leader was this? Well, he certainly had the accolades of the people that day. They even described him as blessed. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. And yet within a week, their songs and praise, their shouts of Hosanna, would become shouts of crucify. And after much back and forth in front of Pilate, as Pilate tried to acquit Jesus, Pilate finally acquiesced, and the crowds had the crucifixion they had demanded. Was there anyone left willing to stand up for Jesus? Yes, though not who we would expect. For it is a soldier, and a Roman soldier at that, who upon Jesus' death proclaims, "Truly this man was God's son." It was not the Jewish leaders, or even Jesus' own followers who have this realization, but a pagan soldier. So where does that leave us? What difference do the events of Jesus' last week mean for us today? What are we supposed to do about it? One way to approach this is to see where you find yourself in the story. Consider the following from Thomas Garlitz. Perhaps we find ourselves in the crowd, waving our patriotic flags and saying we want what is best for society, but too often looking for the quick fix, the easy answers, the short sound bites. Are we like Peter, showy among other religious, but weak in our worldly encounters? Are we like Pilate, knowing what is right, hearing the call of God and needing to take the risk toward our full calling, but giving into our insecurities and our need to be liked? Do we wash our hands of the responsibility of our actions and thus miss the fullness of life offered to us in the total baptismal cleansing? If we answer yes to any or all of these questions, let us pray and give thanks for the graciousness of God and his willingness to